Hello and welcome to News 9. I'm Mr. Dhyan. First up, many students aspiring for a PG seat continued their agitation right in front of the KEA office at Malleshwaram, protesting against the indifference of officials. This is the second day that the protests are continuing. There is confusion over the medical seat allotment, and when the students questioned the authorities, they reportedly tried to hush up the issue. Well, in fact, these were the scenes witnessed in Malleshwaram after students took to the streets in front of the KEA office protesting against the indifference of officials. This is the second day that the protests are continuing. We understand that there is confusion over the medical seat allotment, and when the students questioned the authorities, they reportedly tried to hush up the issue. Several seats are reportedly missing from the matrix. Well, in fact, one of the protesters, Dr. Rashmi, now joins us over the phone line. Dr. Rashmi, if you can tell us what exactly the issue is.
There has been first round of counselling after which seats have been surrendered. People who take seat in All India, they'll surrender seats from the state quota and then go. And these state seats which will be surrendered will come in the second round of counselling. But what has happened is, whatever seats were surrendered in All India, they have like not come to the second round. They have been given to unauthorized random people.
Okay.
After the second round, they are supposed to announce the rank list with the merit list. But what they have done, they have just put the college name and the course name and the student name. They have not mentioned the ranks anywhere.
Okay.
And they have not given it in an order. It is so difficult to figure out the cutoff.
Okay.
And secondly, in February, during MC inspection, there was an increment of 200 seats, of which 30% of the seats have to come to counseling. That is like some 60-70 seats, which they have not displayed in first round of counseling or in the second round of counseling. And after second round of counseling, whatever seats were surrendered, they were supposed to come in the third round of counseling, which they conducted offline. But people who have surrendered the seat, they themselves are telling, I've surrendered the seat, but the seat is not there in third round counseling. Our only question is, like, where are the seats gone?
Okay.
Why is it not merit wise?
So, doctor, you're suspecting that these seats are being illegally sold off to people who have the power to buy?
Yeah, they are being illegally sold to people.
Okay. And you have raised this issue. What is the kind of response you're receiving from the officials there?
They are just like trying to like shy away from this, like telling that aid is transparent, is nothing is done and all. That is what they did. But we made a list of 19 students who have like surrendered the seats, but their seats have like not come in the third round of counseling. And we gave them like a proof. So what they did, they took some time, and yesterday night when we were here till like 10 o'clock, they added 10 extra seats. So if we can like come up with 19 seats in like 2 hours, you never know, hundreds of seats may be scammed and given to unauthorized people. If we can come up with 19, well, then like definitely will be a huge number, which we won't know.
Right, and also, doctor, we understand that many of the protesters have been locked up now. Can you tell us more about that? What exactly is happening?
What?
We understand that many of the protesters have been locked up somewhere by the authorities.
I have no clue about it. I was outside standing and protesting. They like didn't let us talk to them.
Mm-hmm.
Even whatever problems we addressed, they're like not responding properly. They just like come and make their statements. They are like not letting us like talk.
Okay.
They're like not listening to us.
Okay, approximately how many of you are now agitating?
1,500 of us like are here, and like we are protesting. But what they're doing is they've like started the counseling now, telling an assurance they've like given in writing that like we will like look into whatever flaws is happening by fourth round of counseling is what they've told, and they've like started the third round of counseling. But we don't know for how far this is going to like happen and like how far the mistakes are going to be rectified and how many seats will be added in the fourth round of counseling.
And also, doctor, if there is, as you mentioned, there is no favorable response from the authorities, and as per our reports, many of you have even been locked up in the room. So how do you plan to approach this further? Do you plan to approach any higher authorities?
See, we like spoke to DME, but initially what he said is like he can't do anything. Like, this is what he can do. He says second round of counseling, there is computer error. He says he can't do anything about it. If he can't do anything about it, the authorities are just like shying away. They're telling like they can't do anything about it. After like so much protest, they're like given it in writing. Like, they took the 10 of the representatives, they like kept them in the room for some time. And okay. Now they're like let them out, and they like told them that like they'll see to whatever has happened, and by fourth round they like clear everything. But how far this happens, like, we are really not sure. We're like really not hopeful of them, because they are the one who is like made all these things, who like sold the deal or like whatever. And how can we trust them to like come out clean?
Right.
And each medical fee like is worth of like 2 crores, 3 crores. If it's like around, according to our estimate, there is a scam of some 200 ranks. That too,
right.
Every time what would happen is that they would like sell a seat from a private college to the management. But this time, seat from Bangalore Medical College, Mysore Medical College, in Hubli, all the government colleges, seats only, they're like scammed and they're given one not the receipt.
Right, doctor. Thank you for speaking to us and sharing your grievances with us. Well, there we have it. Close to 90 seats, we understand, over 90 seats. Have been identified where the students had surrendered the seats, but the seats have not appeared in the next round of counseling. Instead, these protesting students are alleging that the seats have been sold off illegally. Okay, Fanindra, one of the protesters joins us over the phone line. Now, Mr. Fanindra, we understand that many of the protesters have been locked up in a room. Can you tell us more about that?
Pardon?
Mr. Fanindra, we understand that many of the students have been locked up in the room, the protesters.
Yeah, since morning around 8:30, 9 o'clock, the students have gone in.
Mm-hmm.
And they have requested them not to conduct the counselling unless the seats issue has been disputed properly.
Mm-hmm.
Because around 19 seats that we have identified yesterday had to be sorted out on the spot. That's what our director of medical education had told us yesterday night. But then those 19 seats were not yet updated, so we had asked them to not start the counselling till that is updated properly.
Okay.
And the one more issue that we had was about 70 seats actually had to be added up to our website for counselling, which was not added.
Mm-hmm.
These 70 seats were sanctioned from Medical Council of India in February 2014,
mm-hmm.
which was not yet updated on the website. So we were asking some justice regarding that, and they are not speaking out anything about it. And around 1 o'clock in the afternoon, they have given in writing saying that we'll solve all the issues before fourth round and update all the seats. So now the counselling has started up. And till then, the guys were not allowed to go inside or outside. About 30 to 40 students who had gone in the morning were struck up inside.
Right, and that is illegal confinement. Have you alerted the police or any of the higher authorities about it?
Higher authorities, the director of medical education is aware of it, and he is here since yesterday. And he says he's been pressurized from above other authorities like higher health education minister, etc.
Mm-hmm.
And he's not in a position to do anything, as though he's interested to do some favor to our students. That was one thing we got to know on a personal talk with him. And the police are already here since last, since yesterday, 4 o'clock or so, the police have arrived here.
Mm-hmm.
And they are here since then.
So the police have not done anything to get these students out?
No, the students were not willing to rather come out or anything like that.
Okay.
They only wanted to withhold the counselling.
Okay.
So the ACP had come here and he said he'll speak to the director of medical education and solve the issue. But he too couldn't rectify the issue.
Okay, so, but we understand. But now these students are willingly in that room, or have they been forcefully confined?
Yesterday evening, they were not ready to leave the room unless the counseling issue
okay.
is sorted out.
But today?
Out.
Today?
But today, I was not sure what happened inside.
Okay.
But as per what news I got to know from my friends, it was like they voluntarily were inside to make sure that the counseling doesn't happen before the issue is sorted out.
Okay. Well, thank you, Fanindra, for speaking to us. Well, there we have it. The students have been protesting since yesterday. They do not want the counseling to begin before the issue is sorted out, as they feel that many of the seats that are ideally supposed to be allotted to these rightful students are being sold off for heavy prices to others who have the capacity to buy it. And we also understand that many of the students who until yesterday were unwilling to get out of the counseling center without the counseling process being stopped, today are still inside. Whether they are being forcefully confined or whether they are unwilling to come out in a sign of protest is something that is not clear, as many of the protesters that we have spoken to are the ones who are standing outside, and they seem to be less aware of what is happening inside. Moving on now, a four-year-old girl, a child, has died mysteriously in Bengaluru. The deceased has been identified as Prahalika. She was admitted to Columbia Asia Hospital with severe burn injuries and succumbed today. The girl is suspected to have been murdered by her own parents. They have been taken into custody by the Amruthahalli police. Preliminary investigations have revealed the girl's mother was a widow and had been friendly with the cab driver. The needle of suspicion is now on the cab driver, who is now being accused of harassing and physically abusing the girl. The girl had been admitted to the hospital with some severe burn injuries, but today 4-year-old Prahalika has breathed her last. Quite a shocking incident there being reported from Columbia Asia Hospital in Bengaluru. We understand that the little girl and her family members were residents of Hebbal, and both the mother and her close friend, who is also a cab driver, have now been taken into custody for questioning. And moving on now, a killer KSRTC bus has struck once again. This time, a KSRTC bus rammed into a bike near KR Puram, killing two people on the spot. The accident took place in Battarahalli on Old Madras Road. The deceased have been identified as Gopal Reddy, who is 76 years old, and 45-year-old Reddappa, who was working as a contractor in Devasandra. A case has been registered at the KR Puram Traffic Police Station. Well, we have seen the government buses being in the eye of a storm after many accidents are reported involving the buses. And today, in yet another such incident, a KSRTC bus rammed into a two-wheeler and mowed down two individuals, killing them on the spot. This is the killer KSRTC that you see in the television screens. The incident took place in KR Puram, but of course we know that KR Puram is one of the more crowded areas of Bengaluru. Whether it was a fault on part of the bus driver or whether it was the two-wheeler riders who were at fault that led to the accident is something that will be brought out during investigations. And the KR Puram police will be looking into the case further, as they have registered a complaint in this regard.